Math with Business Applications, Chapter 1, Topics. To start off with, we're going to take a look at the place values for whole numbers. The smallest place value is ones, going up by tens. We're working with a decimal system, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, hundred thousands, and millions. And then once we have a fraction of a one, and sometimes ones are referred to as units, 1/10 of one, one decimal place to the right is tenths. Notice the THS on the end of the word. Next place value smaller is 1/100. Next place value is thousands, 1/1000. 10/1000, 100/1000, and the last place value is millions. Important to know these place values when it comes to rounding numbers. Next, we'll take a look at practicing reading some numbers. This first number is 0.3, but if we read it correctly, we read the number and the last place value of the digit furthest to the right. So the first number here is going to be 3/10. The next number looks like 15, and because the 5 is in the hundredths place, we'll call it 15/100. Some may call this next number 9.2, and we would understand what that means, but if we're being proper in the math world, we would say this is 9 2/10. The next number is 14 185 thousands. The 5 is landing in the thousands decimal place. That's the value that we put on the end then. Rules for rounding. When we're rounding a number, we first need to identify the position to be rounded. It's helpful oftentimes to underline that position. And then the next step is to look at the digit to the right of the rounding position. And the rule is, if that number is 5 or more, increase the position that you're rounding by 1. If the digit is 4 or less, do not change. Once we've made that decision, the fourth step is to change all digits to the right of the underlined digit to 0 if it's a whole number. If it's a decimal number, then you're going to drop all the digits. Here are some examples of numbers. This first one they're asking is to round this number to the hundreds position. So we've underlined the hundreds. Immediately to the right is a 4. This is not a large enough number to alter our 0, so we will call this 45,000. Next number they're asking us to round the number to the 10,000s position. That would be the 6. We look immediately to the right, which is a 5. 5 or greater is our rule, means we'll add 1 to our position that we're rounding. So the 6 becomes a 7. We'll replace the remaining digits to the right of our rounding position with zeros, leaving us with 370,000. The next number is asking us to round to the nearest hundredth. In the hundredths position is 8. Immediately to the right is a 2. This is not large enough to alter the 8. We will replace the 2 with either a 0 or drop it entirely. So our rounded answer to the nearest hundredth would be 12 98 hundredths. This last example here asking us to round to the nearest thousands. In the thousands position is 6. Immediately to the right is 0. Regardless of what's beyond that, it's only the position to the right of where we're rounding that we're looking at. 0 is not a value certainly high enough to alter the 6, so we will call this 0.036 or 36 thousands. Next, we have another type of rounding. This is called front-end rounding. It leaves only the first digit as a non-zero digit. All other digits are changed to zeros. This is a way of getting an answer very quickly when speed is of the essence. Here's an example. If we were using front-end rounding for 76, we look at the front position 7. Immediately to the right is a 6. We still use the rule of 5 or greater to alter our number, so the 7 becomes an 8, and we zero out the remaining digits, and in this case there is only one digit, so we have 80. If we use front-end rounding for 348, The front number is 3, immediately to the right is 4. It's not 5 or greater. We'll leave the 3 and 0 out the other two digits, giving us 300 for a front and rounding answer. Last example here, 23,751, using front and rounding. You look at the lead digit, the first digit of the number. Immediately to the right is a 3. That's not enough to alter the 2. So we will zero out the remaining digits, leaving us with 20,000. And here's an example of where the front end rounding is helpful. In the event you don't have the calculator, the smartphone, and we just want a quick computation or an estimate for an answer. For example, these bills are coming in. Do you have enough cash in your checking account to cover them? Using front end rounding, the 685 becomes a 700. $12.05 is 10. $1,300 front end rounding turns into 1,000, and $88.96 turns into $90. Adding these together, 10 and 90 is 100, with the 700 is 8. Added to the 1,000, we have an estimate of $1,800 or for this total. Here's another example of front end rounding, where if we're just looking for a ballpark, say you're buying 245 items that cost $375 each, approximately what will this value equal? The 245 front end rounding turns into a 200. The 4 isn't enough to alter the 2, zeroing out the other two digits. 3.75 front end rounding. The 7 is enough to alter the 3 into a 4. 2 times 4 is 8, and add your two zeros, we end up with an approximate value of 800.